अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर जनरल साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम पेशावर मॉडल स्कूल नौशेरा कैंपस। हेयर आई एम विद द समरी ऑफ टुडे ऑनलाइन लेक्चर, वाटर साइकिल। वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडी डेट व्हाट इज मीन बाय वाटर साइकिल। द वाटर साइकिल इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ फोर स्टेप्स: एवोपोरेशन, कंडेंसेशन, प्रेसिपिटेशन एंड कलेक्शन। एवोपोरेशन इज अ प्रोसेस व्हेन द सन रेज फॉल ऑन द oceans are seas, so the water absorb the heat of the sun rays and the water is converted into a gaseous state, mean the water vapors. So these water vapors is rises up into the atmosphere. This process is known as evaporation. The next step is condensation. So these water vapor is converted back into tiny droplets of water, and these tiny droplets of water combine together to form a cloud. So this process is known as condensation. The third step is precipitation. When these tiny droplets of water combine together to form a cloud, so these clouds become heavy. So these clouds become heavy and fall on the earth as a rain. So this process is known as precipitation. The last one step is collection. So the rainwater fall on the mountain, ground, rivers and streams. So all this water is flows toward the sea again, and the water cycle begins again. Now move toward the next topic, changes in state of matter. So we have two types of changes in state of matter: reversible change and irreversible change. So reversible changes are those changes in which no new substances are produced. The chemical composition, the chemical makeup of the substance remain same. Only the size, shape and the change in state of matter occur. Okay, and these changes are also known as physical changes. Example are melting, boiling, freezing. The second one is irreversible changes. In irreversible changes, totally new substances are produced. The chemical composition of the substance change. These changes are permanent changes, and it is also known as chemical changes. Example is boiled egg, cooking food. Now this is the exercise of unit number 7. Question number 1 is choose the correct answer, and question number 2 is fill in the blanks. Question number 3 is match column A with column B, and question number 5 is compare the characteristic of solid, liquid and gases in a table below. You have to do this question in your book. Okay, now move toward the written work in neat copies. This is the title page of unit number 7. First in first line you have to give the heading of unit number 7, then in the next line give heading of matter and the water.